you're doing a hell of a job. We're going to try and straighten this thing out. Nice gloves. Thanks.
Looks good.
You think so? Can I have a better look?
Right here, there's a little.
I think that one's pretty warpy when I look at it. But you take a look. When you look at the string action, remember the 25-cent dilemma there?
Yeah, it's like that's maybe $2 right there.
Yeah, but then look at the bridge, though. Look at the saddles, the adjustment. It's all down to the bottom. So it's somewhat of a gooch. I don't think that one's as bad. I think we can just straighten it out. But, okay, so what's the first thing we got to do now that we looked at the neck? Next, what do we check to see what works?
Oh, it works? Oh, that's rod.
Yes. Jeez, you see, you're getting it. Step two. You are the best. Okay.
Good job.
Okay. So, we looked at it, right, Camille?
Mm-hmm.
And it's warped. The neck is warped. Now, once again, we check the truss rod. And if it seems like the truss rod's really tight, like we'd want to do the same thing we just did with the other one.
Mm-hmm.
Except this one, the neck doesn't come off. But that's sort of the solution. Never try and keep turning that if you don't get the neck straight. Loosen it all off and then
do that.
Do the thing with the you know, you can use a straight board. You can use whatever you want to use. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter.
No, yeah.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it actually looks a lot worse than it is. What I think I see is that no one has ever been in there. And what that is just all the paint lacquer buildup in there, and it looks like a big mess,
mm-hmm.
and it looks like it's screwed up, but it's not. It's just shit in the way of the truss rod nut. I can feel it. See, look, I can peel it out, right?
Yeah,
it's just lacquer and part of the finish. Okay, so we might win. Pause.
Winning.
Winning. So what they did is they masked this when they made the guitar. So you can get in there. And then they never took it out. And that's why I could tell. Now once I get all this paper masking shit out of there, mm-hmm. I'm going to be able to get right to it.
Perfect.
Crazy, huh?
Yeah. All those
okay,
years.
Okay, who knew?
All these years. And you're
the first one. But you saw it too. When you first looked at it, it looked like it was just fucked right up. But look, see? It's just masking. Safety last. Look, come and look. Now you can see it.
Oh, yeah, it's perfect now. There we go.
Okay. Hopefully I have the wrench here. If I don't, I don't. I don't. It's metric. Okay. So, it looks like it works. I'm moving it. Let's see if we can straighten the neck out. Once again, I think it's going to be one of those ones where I have to put the wrench on it just to get enough turn on it. Look at that. Well, it's dicey. So what were we talking about earlier about how we wreck this? Right? This is when the neck's warped.
Yeah.
Too much. There's too much twist in it, and we try and take it out. But I don't think there was much tension on this truss rod. I think it just seems a little tight because it's probably never been turned in the life of the guitar.
Mm-hmm.
I hate when this happens. Well, it seems to be straightening out. Yay!
Yay. That's good news.
But like I said, that other bit of nonsense there with the bridge saddles.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I gotta look at it a different way. Well, you know, that ain't half bad. Well, no, it's bad. Well, the other solution to this, which I really,
you know, I don't know. I wouldn't recommend it, but you could, the slots where the strings pass through, mm-hmm. you could carve those deeper.
Oh, okay.
I wouldn't recommend that. Now, the other solution, we take this bridge off, sand the bottom off it, take some material on the, off the bottom side, right, grind that all off to bring this down. But I think that's pretty much as good as it's going to get. That's pretty much it. The next street, I'll talk to him, see if he wants to do anything with the bridge. Beep test. So beeping from there, nada. That's good. But these could be plastic. So what we really want to do is beep from here. It's good ground. This is, seems to be everything that should be there. We flip it over. We'll do a little continuity test from the back of these controls, which is common ground, to this. It's all good. So I'm guessing that was just a loose wire left in there by the guys who built the dot shaft.
It was a gift for later.
Okay, we'll leave that open for now.
Camille, your guitar's got a lot of goo on it.
I know.
Okay, so from what you've learned, what I've taught you, what do you see about your own guitar that you like or don't like?
What I like is the size of it.
Okay, yeah, that's a smaller one.
Yeah, but I know there's a little hump right here.
Yeah, okay. When you look down the neck, what's the deal? Like, is it look straight, or is it, or is no. right at the body joint, there's
yeah,
a little
right here,
hump there?
It kind of comes out. So okay. because of it, okay. I do get some of my fret legs that don't bring out properly.
Okay. And do we know if the truss rod works? It has a truss rod. It's
yeah,
inside,
I've,
right?
Yeah, I've never used it.
Ah, okay.
I'm just sort of looking at the frets, and they seem to be in okay shape. Oh, I know these guitars. I had one like this before. I had a white one. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I see what's going on. There's a bit of a... they seem okay.
There's a few. There's like a, just a few of them that kind
of... And, you know, the playability's not bad, right? Like back to the where we said about a quarter. And so what we can do... I don't really feel that as being a... playability issue. Like every note.
Mm-hmm. There's only on like one or two strings. That...
What I would suggest with a guitar like this though is maybe go to a little heavier, like
yeah.
with we'll get some a little heavier gauge string. Mm-hmm. And there might be a high fret.
Yeah.
Remember the little rocker machine we used? Mm-hmm. Okay, so we can go through that. We'll clean it all up, polish it all up. See, you're as bad as the other. This is just.
I know. Well, I haven't cleaned it in a while.
You guys!
I gotta figure out.
And obviously, there's a battery in there somewhere.
Yeah.
It's oh, it's got the.
See, right here.
Ah, okay. Ooh.
So, pretty cool, eh?
Oh, okay. And it's got the tuner built in.
Yeah.
Right. Battery dead or alive?
Well, it should work.
What do you do? Hold
there you go. So.
It's on. Okay, it's
so
on.
It's on, and then you just pick the note.
Huh? Oh, you have to choose the note, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, next time you come back, this will be your project.
Mm-hmm.
I'll try to find you some strings. These look really light to me.
They
like
are.
You said, a plain G on an acoustic guitar, it's not something.
Yeah, they're electric strings, actually.
Okay, so we're going to turn this off.
Yeah.
We'll just do that. It's off. Okay, so now you know there's still hope. You're missing your strap button.
No, actually, I was trying to put one in.
Well, we can look at that, but that's, you know what? That's really not the good spot for it to go.
Yeah, see, I didn't know.
Where you want it to be is there, on an angle. Because when you put it, if you put it there, the guitar hangs back towards you.
Mm-hmm.
Anywhere else, like there, then when you put it on, the guitar wants to flop forward. But we, you know,
yeah,
we'll get you one, we'll put it there. But if you look, that's the spot. See him?
See,
that's
know.
The spot right there where it goes.
Yeah.
Alrighty.